Good morning, students. Welcome back. Today we are going to start our third chapter of political science, that is election and representation. In this chapter, the points which we are going to cover are: what is democracy? In this subtopic, we will discuss about democracy, how democracy can become the best form of government. Second is types of democracy. Under this subtopic, we will discuss about the types of democracy. Next is Indian electoral system. In this subtopic, we will discuss about the electoral system of country India, how elections go on in our country to choose representatives to run the country in a systematic way. Next is importance of universal adult franchise. Under this subtopic, we will discuss about the importance of universal adult franchise, means right to vote when the people become 18 years old. Then next is role of representatives. Under this subtopic, we will understand the role and the responsibilities of representatives who are chosen by the people of our country, what kind of duties they perform in the country so that country can be governed by them in a nice way. Next is Election Commission and its duties. Under this subtopic, we will come to know about the function of Election Commission, how Election Commission plays an important role to govern the country nicely by helping the representatives. Next is various obstacles in the process of election. In this subtopic, we will discuss about different problems which can be faced by Election Commission during elections. And at last, we will discuss about different suggestions by which we can try to get rid of the problems which can be faced by Election Commission during elections. So, now we are going to start our first subtopic, that is, what is democracy? Students, in our previous classes, for many times we discussed about the different forms of government. Monarchy form of government, dictatorship form of government, and finally democracy form of government. When we used to compare all these forms of government, finally as conclusion, we feel, we observe that democracy is the best form of government. Why? I shall tell you with the help of the definition which was given by Abraham Lincoln. Democracy means form of government of the people, by the people, for the people. Means, under democracy, common people choose common people from the society so that these common people, after becoming representatives, can work for these common people. So, with the help of this definition, we can understand easily that under democracy, the whole power lies in the hand of common people. That's why democracy becomes the best form of government. We can understand this with the help of the process of comparing other forms of government with democracy. When we compare all these forms of government, we feel, we observe that democracy plays the best role as the form of government for its people in comparison of monarchy or dictatorship. Monarchy form of government here dictatorship form of government and finally government. Now, to understand democracy more nicely, more properly, we can start comparing all these forms of government with democracy. First is monarchy form of government. Under this form of government, students, the country can be run by kings or queens. The whole power lies in the hand of kings and queens. So you can imagine if the head of the country is a king or queen, might be the situation can come that most of the time or almost all in all the situations, the kings and queens can think first for their supporters, for their family members, in place of thinking for common people. The rules and regulations which can be framed by them maybe first can be favorable for themselves, for their family members, for their supporters. Instead of thinking for the welfare of common people, goodness of common people, they always work for the sake of their own benefit. So, if this type of activities can be done by the kings and queens and the monarchy form of government, so we cannot imagine that under this kind of a rule, people can grow nicely or common people can move on the way of progress. Now, second is dictatorship. Under dictatorship form of government, the whole power lies in the hand of army officers. The head of the country can be army officers. Again, here we have to understand seriously and sincerely that if the heads are army officers, might be again this situation can come in the country that they can work first for the sake of their own benefits or for the people of their own community instead of working for the common people, for the welfare of common people. Few years back, we have a very good example in Pakistan. General Parvez Musharraf was the head of the country Pakistan. And what happened during his ruling period, everyone knows. He also did not work for the goodness or welfare of common people. He always worked for army officials or the people of his own community. Now, last is democracy, democratic form of government. Here, the common people have the whole power to run the country. Not directly, but indirectly, the whole power lies in the hand of common people. How? As we know, India is a vast country having a huge population, so it cannot be possible for all the people to be the part of a government in the country and then to run the country. So we have a very good process, that is to choose representatives through elections. All the people who are 18 years old or above 18 years old have right to vote. They can vote to the candidates who stand in election and they become the representatives of these common people, and on behalf of them, they work as the part of government. They always work for the welfare of these common people who have chosen them as their representatives. They cannot cheat them because they have full trust from them. And they know very well if they will not work properly, so they will not get chance again to be the part of government for running the country systematically. So when we compare all these forms of government, finally we get a kind of result that democracy is the best form of government, where the people who become representatives always used to work for the welfare of common people. The rules and regulations which they frame all are in favor of common people. For monarchy form of government, students, we can take example from French Revolution. What happened in France when Louis XVI was the ruler of France? So he always used to work for his own sake. He never thought about the goodness or welfare of the common people. He always tried to fulfill the demands of his supporters. He gave special privileges to his supporters, and common people always suffered under his ruling period. And finally, what happened, students? You know very well, all the people, all the common people stood together against him, and finally they were able to establish democracy in their country. Louis XVI was not able to rule longer. His power was under control. He was supposed to follow all the rules and regulations of Constituent Assembly. So in this way we can understand that common people of any country can have the whole power to take care of the country nicely. Now we are moving towards our second subtopic, that is types of democracy. This is also a very easy subtopic where we have to discuss about the types of democracy. Democracy direct democracy and second is indirect democracy. Students, under direct democracy, what happens? The entire people of the country get chance to vote for the candidates equally at a time. Entire population work together directly for candidates to run the country. That is called direct democracy. All the people vote together for the candidates so that these candidates can run the country. Now, under indirect democracy, what happens? All the people vote to choose their representatives who work on behalf of them. That is called indirect democracy, where people direct cannot run the whole country themselves, but they choose few people from the society as their representatives who start working on behalf of them for the goodness and welfare of these common people. By making rules and regulations, by maintaining peaceful atmosphere in the country, by providing them protection and security and so many other duties in the society. So, it's a kind of a classification or division of democracy. Now we are moving towards our next subtopic, that is Indian electoral system. Indian electoral system. Students, under this subtopic we will discuss universal adult franchisee, we will discuss about joint electorate, we will discuss about separate electorate, we will discuss about special electorate. So first we will start with universal adult franchisee. Students, from your junior classes only you are coming to know about this facility, universal adult franchisee, which is provided by our constitution to us. And under this facility, universal adult franchisee, the people who are 18 years old or above, that they have the right to vote, so that they can choose their representatives through the process of election. Then after being representatives, these representatives can work on behalf of them for their welfare and goodness. That is called universal adult franchisee, means right to vote when people become 18 years old or above that. Second is joint electorate. Under this joint electorate process, the entire population used to vote for the candidates so that they can become the representatives and work for their goodness. Next is separate electorate. Students, under the separate electorate, all the people do not vote together. Separate constituencies can be